recognize my life. Ridicule my fight. Give me fuel for the fire burning when I learn these lights.
Cactus Jack and the rest of the Foleys here to wish you a happy holiday hardcore season. You know, I took this time today to kind of explain what Christmas means to me, and by golly, I found out that Christmas can mean a lot of different things. First off, Christmas can be fun! Well, just the other day, there were some Christmas carolers, and I kind of snuck up on their little group, and as the door opened, they began to sing, I started chanting, ECW! 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 And I'll tell you what, I would have gotten away with it, too, except all the neighbors heard me saying, bye-bye! As I ran out of the neighborhood, but, you know, they didn't care. They just know that said Nutty Cactus Jack, and I'll tell you what, they realized it doesn't hurt to have a hardcore person in the neighborhood. Second off, Christmas is for family. Well, just the other day, I was taking Gingerbread Men out of the oven, but I'll tell you what, I kind of saw that cookie sheet, and I was kind of wishing I could bowie! I hit someone over the head, right in the kisser. Bet you get some juice out of that one. Bang, bang!
When cotton swabs are dipped in the exotic fluid known as tape recorder cleaner, a marvelous process begins.
Applying the damp swab to the tape heads and tape guides loosens microscopic particles of dirt.
Dirt, in this case, is defined as any loose, grubby bits of yuck that might get in the way.
And where, you may ask, did all this dirt come from? The kid down the street. Pollution. The recording tape. Time's up. Did you get the right answer? Good. Yes, the recording tape is where most of the dirt comes from, with a little help from the other two.
The stuff we call recording tape is a multi-layered laminate of plastic, microscopic, magnetizable particles, and some sort of glue to hold it all together. When tape is physically pulled over a solid object like a recording head, tape guide, or capstan, a small portion of the particles at the surface of the tape break off and start to pile up on things. Magnetism. It's what tape recorders are all about. From the magnetic twist of the electric motors right down to the magnetic impressions of the sound on the tape, it's all the same stuff.
The trouble is, if you were a tape head, magnetism would love you so much it would stick to your face and alter your performance. This does happen, and it's a good idea to give your pet recorder an occasional magnetic bath. Here's your electronic scrub brush, the tape head demagnetizer. This gadget makes a strong alternating magnetic field, powerful enough to erase residual magnetism that's hanging on to the tape heads and guides. Like anything good, there's a trick to using it. Lesson number one, never use a demagnetizer near recording tape. Remember, the demagnetizer erases magnetism, and you don't want it to erase the magnetic impressions on your tapes now, do you? 6 feet is the recommended safe distance. Lesson two, turn off the tape machine, or you will hear the most awful buzz through the playback head you ever heard in your life. Lesson three, turn on the demagnetizer. Is there anyone who doesn't understand lesson three? Good, we'll continue. Lesson four, bring the demagnetizer near the tape heads without touching them. The tape guides and recording heads are machined to precise tolerances and are so finely polished that any scratch from metal objects that touch them could damage them or cause them to scratch the tape. If the working tip of your demagnetizer is bare metal, you can put a short length of flexible tubing or masking tape on the tip to protect the machine. Lesson five, cover the tape path with those invisible magnetic rays. Here's where your headache goes away. Just a few seconds near each part, moving slowly, caressing each tape head and guide with soothing magnetic relief. Lesson six, slowly remove the demagnetizer from the tape machine, then turn it off. As the magnetic field of the demagnetizer leaves the area, the residual magnetism goes along for the ride. If you turn the demagnetizer off near the heads, you will have thoroughly magnetized your machine and you'll have to start all over.
Feeding the beast. You are what you eat, and the same holds true for your tape recorder. And you feed your recorder two ways, the tape you use and the music that goes in, so you really have to stay aware of what's going into your machine and even where it's going in.
What do you say you want?
Have you tried the cream soup yet?
No.
Spit out the bomb onto this melody. I'm John F. Kennedy. She Maryland's jealousy. The dead presidency. I died, just fell asleep. Come and sleep along. Only sweep from God. It's deeper to evil on songs. Read my wrong. Guitar strings pull out word of bond. Life is the last straw. You know who we are. Dime bags and fed to me. I be the friend of she. Command my free. Omen sell liberty. Say church that you believe. Sounds like a new belief. She been a new belief. My shit, she googling. It's like without the settling. I'm all up in her mind. Peddling. Couldn't imagine airing me. Pantera's alchemy. Metal to empathy. Wetter than ecstasy. They're all the enemy. But I'm past assassinate. I run fast. I let that rabbit chase. My absence hate. Lacerate. My back today without a damn to take. When I'm out, I gravitate. As to emancipate. Cash flow to smoke away. Cash flow my phone into place. He into me. Young and intimate. Sprung off the lyrics I brung. I think she seriously sung.
Motherfucker.
understand, there's a hardcore balloting going on that Todd Gordon's in charge of the votes. But more importantly, Todd Gordon is the head of some very prestigious and worthwhile children's charities. And I'd like to be the first at this special time of the year to write a generous check. Seeing as I don't know the names of the particular charities, I'm just going to make it out to Todd Gordon himself, and I think Todd will know what to do with it. Honey, zoom in here so you can look at all these zeros, okay? Not too close, or we're allowed to have 1,500 hardcore fans out there chanting, "He's hardcore! He's hardcore!" Like I got, I love them, and if it was up to me, I'd have them all in for a couple of hot chocolate.
When you give your tape recorder a tape to play with, are you selective? Do you give it the right formula? Do you give it tape with an optimum daily requirement of bias and equalization? Check your instruction manual for the right tape to use with the settings on your machine. Or have your family serviceman adjust your machine to the kind of tape you use the most. The right tape for the right machine, better than vitamins. And if you want the very best results, well, let's just say cheap tape is cheap tape.
Presented as a public service by the committee to call attention to the fact that the right tape is usually far better than cheap tape.
We'll return with more commercials after this announcement.
Okay, it says here the videotape's open. Oh, it's more. Wait a minute. Yeah, right, I got that, right, yeah. Oh. Hey, where's Part B? Is Part B around here someplace? It is around here someplace. Do you know where it is? Would you find it, please, for me, would you, please? Thank you. Cute title, huh? Cute. Real cute. How did they know? I mean, I was, but how did they know? Yeah, could you find Part B for me, please? Would you find it? It's got to be here someplace. I mean, they come together. There's two parts. Definitely, that's all there is. I mean, you got to find that other tape, or else we're going to miss a lot.